Within 60 seconds of Ethiopian Airways Flight 302's taking off from Addis Ababa Airport on Sunday morning of March 10th at 8:37 a.m., Captain Yared Gattachu, with 8,000 hours of flying experience, immediately knew something was wrong.
The plane is not climbing like it should.
ATC, there seems to be a flight control problem.
Air traffic controller's radar showed that the aircraft's altitude was well below what is known as the minimum safe height from the ground during a climb out. But by 120 seconds, the plane climbed to a safer altitude.
I want to stay on course till 14,000 feet.
Then suddenly, out of nowhere, in perfectly clear weather, the plane went into a dive. Audible warnings flashed. Sink rate, sink rate. But within 9 seconds, they were able to control it and the plane resumed climbing. Ground controllers, sensing an emergency, radioed other approaching Ethiopian flights, 613 and 629.
Incoming flights, remain at your altitude till further notice. Repeat, remain at current altitude.
Moments later, the craft dived once again. 3 minutes after takeoff, Yared radioed the terminal, this time in panic.
Break! Break! Request back to home! Request vector for landing!
By then, the stick shaker in the cockpit was shaking violently, making a high rattling noise, warning the pilot that the aircraft was about to stall. A stall happens when the AOA, or angle of attack, that is the angle between the wind and the aircraft, which should typically be just a few degrees, rises. Anything higher than 10 degrees can lead the aircraft to stall, that is, to stop moving forward fast enough to stay airborne. The exposed large underbelly and wings of the aircraft resist rushing winds, creating a drag. With the wings not generating any lift, the aircraft will plummet straight down. Have you ever tried moving forward in heavy breeze? It kind of slows your progress. Boeing 737 MAX's AOA sensor is installed on the outside of the plane to keep track of the angle at which wind is passing over its wings. That sensor malfunctioned. When the plane was actually flying correctly, the sensor informed the computerized system that its nose was too high. Immediately, the newly installed automated MCAS used stabilizers located on the tail to push the nose back down to what it thought was a safer angle, but it actually pushed the plane into a dive. Because the main body of the 737 is already quite low, when Boeing's engineers installed the larger, more fuel-efficient engine LEAP 1B for the 800 MAX, they put it further outwards on the wings so as to avoid it scraping the ground. But that minor change created aerodynamics that tilted the nose marginally upwards. To counter this, Boeing developed a new software, Maneuvering Characteristics Augmentation System, or MCAS. In the Lion Air crash of 2018, the sensor falsely showed the plane pointed up 20 degrees higher than it actually was. Pilots in both flights used stabilizer trim controls at their thumbs that handle the nose up and down movement to temporarily counteract the automated MCAS. But every time the plane stabilized to the correct angle, within 5 seconds the system would re-engage, pushing the nose down again at an angle of 2.5 degrees every 10 seconds, creating a tug of war between the pilot and the software. Can you imagine what the passengers on the Lion Air flight were going through as the plane lurched up and down 24 times continuously? Finally, the pilot switched off the computer system and tried to manually control the dive. In unison, they pulled on their control columns in an effort to keep the jet aloft. But the plane kept diving. 6 minutes after takeoff, the plane dived into a field, killing all 157 on board. The Lion Air JT610, captained by Delhi resident Bhavya Suneja on October 29, 2018, was flying from Jakarta, Indonesia to the tin mining town of Pangkal, Penang, when it developed the same problem 5 minutes after takeoff and plunged 5,000 feet at 720 kilometers per hour into the Java Sea, killing all 189 on board. Actually, the Lion Air flight should never have taken off in the first place, as pilots flying the same aircraft a day earlier,
the stick shaker vibrated continuously through the flight and we had to shut off the system and fly manually. Make sure the plane is checked.
But it was cleared for takeoff the next morning. Cutting corners notwithstanding, air safety has improved so much in recent years that the Lion Air crash was the only fatal flight in over 2.5 million flights in 2018. Unfortunately, Boeing did not feel it necessary to inform the pilots about MCAS. There is no mention of it in either Jet Airways 1488 page or SpiceJet's 1016 page flight crew training manual or the 90-point PowerPoint presentation explaining the upgrade. The only place where it shows up is the MEPS training manual on page 452. Good luck finding it in an emergency. MCAS allows the stabilizer to move in the nose down direction when approaching high angle of attack at high speeds. High speeds are classified at around 350 knots at 10,000 feet and above, but both doomed flights had just taken off and were at 250 knots and well below 5,000 feet height. Still, MCAS triggered. Pilots trained on a simulator were successfully able to deal with the problem, but that is a costly exercise where each pilot would need to be trained for a minimum of 4 hours, delaying the launch of the MAX 8. When countries first grounded the 737 MAX, Boeing and the FAA tried to underplay the risk. Transportation Secretary Elaine Chao flew along with a staff from Texas to DC on a MAX 8 2 days after the crash.
"We want to ensure everyone that the 737-800s are safe."
Despite this show of bravado, thousands of passengers bombarded Southwestern American Airlines.
"Please change my flight ticket from MAX to another cargo aircraft or cancel it."
While flight attendants unions demanded their employers,
"Ground the MAX."
Boeing, that generously contributes to the Republican Party, called up President Trump and lobbied for support.
"Mr. President, I want to personally assure you that the planes are safe to fly."
But satellite images by Iron showed convincingly that both crash patterns were similar. Though Lion Air pitched up and down 24 times and Ethiopian 4, it is highly unusual for jets to descend at all after takeoff. As more countries joined in to ground the jets, on the third day of the crash, Trump made a unilateral announcement forcing Boeing's hand.
"All of those planes are grounded, effective immediately."
The single-aisle 737 MAX 8 with 4,600 orders was the fastest selling plane in the company's history and was poised to generate $550 billion in future revenues as they race to making 57 planes per month. They now expect to lose over $1 billion and be hit with a number of lawsuits, the first of which was recently filed in a US federal court in late March.
"From Rwanda for the family of Jackson Musoni."
Boeing had promised to update their software by the end of 2018, but dragged their feet.
"Software fix will be available soon. It has been rigorously tested."
Had they done so, many lives could have been saved. To save costs, many airlines don't have the AOA display in their cockpits, for which Boeing charged extra. This has now been made mandatory by the FAA. The MCAS update will now rely on data from two sensors, not just one, and will notify pilots if those sensors have conflicting readings. Airbus, on the safer side, uses readings from three sensors. Plus, the system would be redesigned to kick in just once and not repeatedly as before, while making it easier for the pilot to override the system. In India, the Airbus A320neo too had problems with its Pratt & Whitney 1100 engines, which had 69 mid-air failures in 18 months. Corrosion due to high humidity is suspected to be the reasons for these problems. Meanwhile, the FAA has simply been rubber-stamping self-certification by airliners without doing their own tests.
"We would need 10,000 more people and $1.8 billion more to test everything independently."
Clearly, the airline industry is in turmoil. While Boeing will have to regain the flyers' confidence, airlines too cannot afford to be lax on maintenance. Do see my other videos on the aviation industry. Bisbo's limerick. Passengers in the MAX 800 met an unfortunate end. Incomplete training is not something Boeing can defend. To the market they rushed. Many lives did they crush. And for that, Boeing will have to make amends. Subscribe to Bisbo's channel and be sure to click on the bell icon. Be the first to know when Bisbo releases a new video.